What's up, guys? It's me, Kareem Jovian Games, and we have a lot to talk about. But before we start, I want to say I do have a giveaway that I'm doing for the Xbox Series X. And to find out more information about that, it's in the description box below. Don't leave now. We need to talk. Let's set the mood right. Alexa, Cyberpunk.
Wake the f*** up, Samurai.
And then she plays some Cyberpunk music. It's pretty dope. It's pretty cool. She takes some time, but it's awesome. Let's begin. Yes, it's pretty obvious. I'm a lot more hyped now than I was before because I got a little more deeper into the game and oh man, it is, whew. I'm not a person to overhype anything and believe me, I don't like overhyping things because I always get disappointed and I don't want to disappoint you guys, but you're gonna have a lot of fun. For the people who love GTA and keep comparing it to GTA, you might actually be kind of right and you're probably gonna like this. No spoilers, so don't worry about that. And at the same time, I'm not gonna give too much detail, no character names or anything like that. You won't know anything, but I will be talking about the mechanics in the game. So if that's something that you don't wanna hear about, then I would suggest you just watch another video, but it would be awesome if you could stick around. Took notes here. This eye zoom feature, right? It's done in a really cool way. If you press the left trigger or L2, you get to zoom in at any point in the game. So, you know, if you're looking at someone, you don't have to walk up really close. You could just zoom in. And it's like, it's implemented. It's like video game based. It could get hacked and you can't zoom. And it's pretty dope. So you have it, you know, it's in your eye. It's like, you just start off with it. If you guys don't know what I'm talking about, maybe if you ever played Metal Gear Solid games, during the cutscenes, you're always able to like zoom in with the L2 button and kind of like zoom in on like the cinematic scenes and kind of move it a little bit. Yeah, I mean, I thought that was cool. If you guys think that's cool, that's awesome. Cinematics, yeah. There is like a major cutscene that kind of builds your relationship with someone, which is really dope and really awesome. Everything I'm talking about is already recorded. I will be releasing it on December 10th when the game comes out, just to be fair and not break any rules. But I will talk and describe it to the best of my ability without giving away too much. So yeah, you have this really cool character building thing, but it's all done in first person. The only time you get to see yourself is when you look in the mirror, and it worked. It freaking worked. Imagine like a beginning of a movie and you and the other person just effing shit up. Another question that you guys had was, can you see yourself in first person when you look down? And I can happily say yes. So you could actually see yourself, you see your hands, your arms and everything when you look down, when you're sitting, you can see your pants and some of your shirt during any of the times you look down. So that's also in there and that's freaking awesome and it's cool and it's done well. I mean, I can't believe I'm saying this, but I'm actually kind of happy this game is first person because there's a lot of scenes that happen to where you're being driven. You're really in there, you know, when someone comes up with a gun or someone comes around you or when you're being tailed or whatever it is. I never knew I wanted because in GTA, whenever you had a car and a drive-by or whatever, you would see it from the third person perspective, or there had to be a cinematic for them to set it up for you. You are in the moment, everything is being set up for you. And there's so many dialogue options, man. I feel like this is insane. You can pull off some GTA. There is a leveling up system, so you can't steal any car. You have to basically be leveled up in order to steal certain cars or whatnot. And on top of that, I'm gonna say this, it's way better than GTA. Another thing that's also GTA inspired, you get to rack up stars. Yes, I think there's 5 stars. If you're driving and you run over people, the NCPD will come after you. When I racked up the maximum stars, my car blew up. I don't know how that happened or where they came from, but damn, you don't wanna mess with the NCPD. They're very ruthless and they are intimidating. Another cool thing is that you could actually help them out. You could work with them if you want, or you could work with gangs. It's just really cool, a lot of side missions. And by the way, if you guys have a GOG account, be sure to link it to Cyberpunk as soon as you can, because you can get exclusive gear in your game based on the Witcher 3 series, which I thought was really dope. You get a Witcher 3 t-shirt and a Witcher 3 jacket. My character's wearing them and he looks badass. Maybe I can show you that. All right, here's a clip. The game really respects your time. When you're in a car and there's a long conversation or the drive is gonna be long, you can skip it. You could also skip to a certain time. You choose the time you want the day to be at, do it in the settings, and it fast forwards to that time. A lot of upgrades for certain abilities that you have, like net running. You could have quests that pop up for net running, so you could upgrade your net running skills, which is, I almost forgot about this actually. Again, another GTA inspired thing is that you have a cell phone and you can call your friends or you call people in the game or characters or whatever, and ask for jobs, ask for requests, and they can call you at any time, and you could choose to pick up the phone or not. At your place, you could watch TV, right? And there's so many freaking funny ads. When you get the game, watch every single ad. They are insane. And I'm gonna tell you right now, for the SJWs out there, when this game gets released, a lot of people are gonna be mad. A lot of people are gonna be pissed. And I think that Cyberpunk and the team, like the Cyberpunk game and the team who made it, like, they gave no Fs. And I think that's just freaking awesome. And that's what makes this game special. They gave no Fs, they went there, they took it to the maximum level, and they didn't care. They didn't take anything out. And yes, that picture of that lady with the enlarged part of the body is still there, and she is prominent everywhere, so that's good. They didn't take that out. Get updates on the news, you can watch a TV show. Believe it or not, I'm actually really upset the patch is not here yet, because I want to update this game already. You can go on the internet in the game. There's websites, you can visit websites. I think you could buy things from online. There's also a samurai website, which is pretty freaking dope. So believe me, that's all I'm gonna say. You could check that out when you get the game and just find all the little details. Go to every website and just have at it. There's a huge looting system. You could pick up a lot of stuff. Sadly, when you pick something up, it just disappears and it goes into your inventory. I don't mind that at all. The settings you have in the game are so customizable. You could really make the game work how you like. I actually turned off Dead Zone. I don't like Dead Zone. I turned off the blurs. I turned off chromatic aberration. I turned off the film grain. I just want my game to be running smooth and, yes, as crisp as possible. I found a studded dildo in the game and I picked it up. I don't even know what I'm gonna use it for. I have it in my inventory. Oh, and finally, there are slots in weapons like The Witcher, so you can upgrade your weapons, kind of buffs up your weapons. Oh, I almost forgot. It's the combat. Okay, the combat is pretty limited from what I've seen, but maybe you can upgrade it, but it's completely fine. But it's cool. You got your basics, right? What I thought was really cool is you also have some MGS and Hitman inspirations. Characters will have an exclamation point above their heads if they notice you in red. It's like in a little box. And if they are suspicious, they'll have like a yellow icon with an eye that would fill up or go down as you are hiding. So you can hide, there's stealth. That's so cool. You can sneak up on people, you could take them out with a kill or take them out in a non-lethal manner. Enemies can find bodies. If they find the body that you just killed or knocked out, it's gonna cause problems for you. So what you can do is you could actually hide bodies in like garbage cans or whatever. And it's really cool that they added that. So I thought that was dope, and I think you guys might like that too. There's also VR missions. It's like a VR missions-esque type thing where you're learning all this. So yeah, I hope that didn't ruin anything. If anything, it just made it a lot more exciting, because there's just really cool mechanics in the game, and I think they pulled it off pretty nicely. That's pretty much everything that I wanted to talk about. There's a lot more, and I'm so excited that you guys are gonna get to play this game, and I'm so excited we're finally getting it, that we hung in there and we just managed to really pull through. It's been a rough year, and I think this is an amazing way to just kind of end it, you know, with something that we've all really wanted, that's gonna help us pass the time and just enjoy our time. I think it's gonna be really cool. And hey, if they're gonna have another lockdown, bring it. I mean, I'm game. Thanks guys for the support and just coming through and watching my videos. Seeing that you guys are enjoying it really means a lot to me, so thank you. Since you guys watched till the end, I'm gonna drop a code right here. This code is for 3 months free of Stadia Pro. You could also play Cyberpunk on that. And believe it or not, I have actually seen people saying that they can't afford a console and they don't have the right PC to play this game. And it made me feel really bad. I feel like anyone should be able to play this game. Hey, use that code, you get 3 months free of Stadia Pro, you get your game, and the best thing is, you get to play Cyberpunk 2077 at ultra settings with Stadia Pro. All you need is just an internet connection. Make sure your internet connection is good, of course. And with Pro, you get to play it in 4K. I really was rushing through this video. I do apologize if it felt like that. I just really want to get back to playing. I'm serious. I love you guys, and I will see you soon. And yeah, peace.